Hello, 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 and welcome to a let's play of some RogueTech. So, I'm not going to get too deep into the weeds here, but Battletech, Backer Beta, all that. My most anticipated game of the year. I thought this game was terrible, and I realize pretty much everybody watching this probably really likes the game. I thought the base Battletech game was a failure on almost every level. It's my personal opinion on it. Didn't beat it, don't plan on beating it, have no interest in ever starting it again. Zero. I think there's a little bit of extenuating circumstances, especially when you look at a small company like Harebrained Schemes, and what you realize is that their budget was probably fairly tight at a smaller company like that, and the Harmony Gold lawsuit, I'm just almost sure that the legal costs really were more than honestly a small studio would ever expect. I don't think that was ever counted in, and so I think there's some stuff that was kind of going on in the background that probably led to less development on this game than I would have liked. And that's just my personal opinion on it. I'm not going to get into it too much, you know. We'll just leave it lay right there. RogueTech, on the other hand, I am in love with this mod. This mod is so much fun. There's a huge proliferation of items and weapons and mechs inside of it. Of course, most of the mechs don't have models yet, but, you know, things will they'll pick up at some point. So there's really a lot of choices on, you know, what do I want, what plays more to my style, and that's even in the gear and stuff. The lost tech is not really a big deal at this point in the timeline. But even just fighting in the Fourth Secession War, I can go where I want to, and I think, you know, some of the just RPG elements that you find right at the beginning of the game really do affect they do have some effect on gameplay, but it seems to hold honestly a more Battletech character than what I would find in the base game. I don't know, that's just kind of all my personal thing. So let's go ahead and start a new custom campaign. We're gonna go Iron Man, which is probably a moron move, because I will be taking the Capellan Confederation, which I haven't tried the Federated Sons, and I won't because I hate them. Victor Davion, I'm pretty sure, is the leader right now. If not, he's going to be very soon, because I believe he's the Davion that fights the clans. I don't like him. They can go, you know, something, something, something that I'm not going to really pronounce here. Free Worlds League, I could really, you know, just take or leave. It's not, they don't mean much to me. I find Lao a bit more interesting, you know, the Capellan Confederation. Really, I'm a big fan of Steiner. And Kurita would probably be, you know, my second. Draka's Combine, very interesting. I really love the fluff surrounding them. Now, I will say I'm pretty far in my Steiner and my Kurita playthrough. Well, not pretty far. I'm decently far. I'm through, I would say, the beginning phases of the game. And this will be my fourth start with the Capellan Confederation. And I don't know if this is really something that you're going to see in Davion and Merrick. But I'm pretty sure this is the hard mode for this game, and not intentionally. Not intentionally. Everything else we're just going to leave at whatever the bases are. So, I'll kind of talk about that as we go through the gear here, because I think that, well, why am I waiting for that? We've got a loading screen here. I think what you find is that the weapons tend to make your mechs a little, you know, more bring the threat level, danger level, whatever number the game runs in the background, because I didn't change that. The difficulty will scale with my lance and how good my lance is. The thing is, with Lao at one skull mission types battle, just battle, not assassination, just battle. Once I put all my gear on, every time when I've done a one skull mission, and every time it's been three missions in, what I run into is lances with medium mechs, and I have not witnessed that in... Honestly, I really kind of wanted to check out the various mechs to see how they played, so I actually did start probably a fair number of Steiner and Karita games just because I was curious what kind of mechs this game, which variations did it have. Didn't see that at all. You only saw them really in the assassinations. I think there's one other type where you normally see a mech heavier than the weight class you're currently fighting. We're just going to go ahead and skip this. We'll leave it. Sweet. Man, just what I want to do. I do kind of wish I could maybe occasionally fight against some of the known mercenary companies. That would just make me cream my shorts just completely. Anyways, as I was saying beforehand, these are not just like fluff anymore. And by fluff, I mean really not even... I mean, why do you pick it? Those of us familiar with the setting, yeah, you want to come from a certain place, but it really had no effect on anything at all. Now these come with items. In fact, the attributes as well will come with items on them. And these seem quite thematic overall. I'm going to be completely honest. Like, the Drake's Combine is one heavily molded. I probably would have said model, but around medieval Japanese society. I can't believe I misread that and then read it correctly at the same time. So this is Way of the Bushido. Generally, when you think of the Drake's Combine, they have very big, very heavily armored mechs, or they have very, very close-range brawlers. Now, it's not to say they don't have some long-range weaponry, but that's generally just to throw a little bit of fire as you close into that brawler range and maybe get in for some melee combat. You know, your dragons, your Kentaros. A lot of Jenners, honestly, as well, were used. I'm not so much sure about, like, the Fourth Secession War here, because that's when things really start to shift. But I think these really reflect it. You have the light PPC, you know, very short-range PPC, but still pretty decent damage. The Snub-Nose PPC, honestly, pretty good range for being the Snub-Nose, but still that... It describes the Snub-Nose PPC when you read the description of it as basically a sawed-off shotgun, but you do that with a PPC, and it's very true. PPC capacitor to increase the damage, but the heat at the same time, so again, you want to close into that melee range and maybe start punching a little bit when you get a little hot with all those PPCs running, and then some deadfire SRM, LRM ammo. You lose some range, you lose some ability to hit, but they hit harder. It's a close range, you know, get-in-their-face type of feeling. The thing is, I think this all ties into, I believe, why the Capellan Confederation, I'm seeing completely different things here. They come with stealth armor, a null signature system, electronic warfare suite, and an electronic countermeasures. So you have two ECMs and two stealth systems, basically. I think, and there's a huge, I should say, there's also, because of other choices I'm going to make, I'm actually going to continue to grab more ECM out of the other choices coming up. What you're going to find, though, is that I think the game, for Lance value, because the game takes place when most of this, null signature system, stealth armor, this is all lost tech in the base game. So I think when you have this on your lances, the game is actually looking at a lot of these periphery systems, not weapons, as far greater value than what they should be, because at this point I'm finding it extremely hard to believe that, coincidentally, that many times, every single time I try it, I'm running into these mediums that few battles into the game on a one-skull mission. And I believe they were all versus two lances, and I believe all of them had two medium mechs in it. And I'm not seeing medium mechs till I get to the skull and a half with any of my Steiners, and like I said, or any of the Drake's Combine. And I did start over quite a few times because I really did kind of want to see the mechs. I tend to start over a little bit if I get just a handful of mechs that I, or variations of mechs that I think are just ridiculously bad to start with. I probably won't since I'm recording here, but that's fine. So now you can pick your attributes, or you can go ahead and choose a like anti-missile system. You're gonna get that with it anyways. Do you want a particular piece of gear, or do you want particular attributes on your character? I have not tried the Stahlbrick 10 gyro. I know that the Friedhof Kite gyro is so good, so very good. I would say it's probably the standout here. And the small cockpit, even if I wanted the combination of tactic guts, I would never take this because the small cockpit is terrible. It's bad, and I don't know why it's a choice here. We're going to be going with the gunnery tactics, not because I think the anti-missile system's any good. In fact, I probably won't use it. But I would like that combination of attributes. Again, these are just for a single plus one that you can pick now. There's no two attributes for one, but each of these are going to come with two things. Now, I haven't. Is it the reactive plating or the reactive coating? Reactive plating, I believe, is the one I haven't seen yet. So that might be good. Honestly, Haywire EMP's kind of nice, but I believe it is a 3-ton support weapon. So I do have a bit of a hard time on, the finding a place to put it kind of early in the game. But yeah, again, I would say Frontier Pirate, you already start off with an LRM-10 unless you just really like missile boats. That way you can have two LRM-10s in the beginning. Probably not any good. The Tagger, that does give you a plus one to hit when it's really hard to hit early in the early phases of the game. But it's just not that good either. It's got damage fall off, only 8 damage on it. It's a tag, but it has slightly more damage with damage fall off, basically. However, the standouts, I would say, honestly, are Soldier. I lie, I haven't done the chainsaw either. I've had medium combat shields, though. The Soldier and the Frontier Freelancer, honestly, the Gladiator might be pretty decent, too. The medium combat shield is quite nice. The tag are early in the game if you don't end up with a tag, just that plus one to hit. It's very long range, but it's also a support weapon, so you can fire it melee, meaning you can really shoot it from huge differences of distance overall. And plus one to hit means a lot early in the game. Command console, I would say, is so very good. Plus one initiative on a mech is great. The problem with the command console is it's kind of hit or miss, much the same as the Haywire EMP. This takes the place of your cockpit, and it weighs 6 tons. Cockpits normally weigh 3 tons, so you basically have to scrounge up an additional 3 tons, which is a little hard, kind of sometimes on your starting mechs. But the command console, I've gotten great value out of it when I have been able to put it down. And the Frontier Freelancer, which is the Endo Steel. I've only had one game where everything I had Endo Steel on it, and I only started with three mechs, all three mediums. So generally speaking, you can put the Endo Steel right in right away and then begin upgrading. You don't have to hope to pick some up after the battle. And the Angel ECM, not as good as the Electronic Warfare Suite, but pretty dang good. Pretty dang good. Honestly, the Angel ECM's a little more defensive. The Electronic Warfare Suite has a little more offensive side to it, but both are quite good. And we're actually going to be going with this right here because I really want that Angel ECM. Let's see. It's Marvin, sure. I'm not going to get too worked up about this. Well, I want something I can pronounce, though. Marvin Travis? That seems like two first names. What the hell? Arius. Marvin Arius. That'll work. Marvin Calvo, that'll work. Okay. Queen Bee, that would be very weird for a male, in my opinion. Tornado, Scepter. Okay, Gator, that's fine. And Eeny, Meeny, Miny, that one'll work. Not honestly, I just don't care. Being a mercenary, though, we just go wherever there's money and trouble, and everyone in the galaxy is a customer. I'll just say it. I do wish they had taken a little more, of that approach with the campaign. It would have been kind of nice. Okay, so here we are. I'm assuming most people that are watching this, Okay. Sometimes I start off with 9 tech points, and sometimes 8, and sometimes I'm like 2 and a quarter, basically, million sea bills, and sometimes I'm under 200,000. Just I haven't quite figured that out. Maybe there's a little bit of variation there. So let's go into engineering. So I will say I've been watching Molten Metals Let's Plays. That's what actually got me to re-download the game and get into it. This awesome mod. He says, you know, I think that this is the first thing you should go for. It's 4 extra tech points, so that's a 50% increase, and we can work on a second mech at 50% efficiency, so 6 points once we have it. I'd say, after having played the game, I would definitely agree with him, although this is going to cost 700,000, and you do need the repaired power conduits, which is 90,000. I'd go a step farther and say you're also going to need automation, which is 450, enables the second repair bay to work at 100% efficiency, and an additional 2 tech points, which you'll be at 12 at that point, so you're not looking at nearly the gains of the first one, but still extra tech points, and you get the 2 extra tech points, and that whole second mech that you're working on gets done faster as well, you know, after battles and things like that. And I would also say, because it's fairly cheap, the training module here, 30 experience a day doesn't seem like a lot, but taking rookie pilots into some of the later missions that I've run into when I've had to do it, it can get a little hairy. Well, excuse me, I am so sorry about that. So we're going to grab the power conduits right off the bat, and I actually have went and tried some different things here, including souping up the current mechs I get, the game where I started with 3 mechs, went in. We'll check the store real quick. Because I will say, if you happen to see a mech that you like here that you can actually afford, which none of this is stuff I can afford right now, but just say, I don't know, there were 100 Locust 1 V2 parts, and I'm like, I really like the Locust, so I want to go ahead and I want to grab that up, you know? I don't know, I like the Rocket Launcher 10s, even though I don't. What you're going to find is that the game has no ability to differentiate between battlefield salvage mechs, and even if you buy all 5 parts out of the store, what should be kind of new mechs, in quotations, which I'll get to in just a moment. So when I ended up buying this really cool, it was a Locust IIC 2 or 3, I don't remember now. It was developed by Clan Hellhorse. The thing had a Clan ER large laser, 2 small pulse lasers. I was going to pull those off and throw a LRM-5 on it, along with probably like a half-ton ammo. I could pull 45 points of armor off because the thing was armored up incredibly good. And then I had this great long-range fire support that shouldn't be taking really any damage ever. It turns out, though, that what I ended up with was a mech that I didn't have the ultralight gyro. I didn't have the XL engine. I didn't have the endo still, I didn't have the advanced materials, I didn't have the clan heat sinks, I didn't have clan double heat sinks, I didn't have the ER clan large laser, I was short one of the small pulse lasers. So what I ended up with was basically like a Locust 1S? No, 1M. 1S is the SRM version, 1M is the LRM version. So yeah, it was a complete waste of money, and it cost me almost like a million bills, and for whatever reason, like the moron I am, I'm like, oh, I just got to get it running. So I ended up throwing like another million at it, and just, I had no upgrades. I was able to pull the game out of a tailspin spiral, but it very hard because I had no replacement gear, I had no replacement mechs. It did get quite hairy down the road. I could see buying one of these if you're short like a piece and you don't think you're going to see another one anytime soon. At that point, buy one. It's not a big deal, but as far as buying multiples of these, yeah, wouldn't do it. The gear, though, is kind of interesting in this because a lot of this takes place online, and what you're going to find is that as players do missions wherever you happen to be doing missions, in this case, the Capellan Confederation, what you're going to find is that the gear that you don't pick, it goes into a pool along with the gear that all the players sell. And every, I believe, 30 minutes, this store updates. And all the stuff it's going to have comes out of that pool. That is just so fantastic. Well, I don't believe all of it because I think the ammo, there's always some ammo here. The half-ton ammos, anyways. So, yeah, I really, really do kind of enjoy the dynamic store. And honestly, the star map's the same way. There's actually the Fourth Secession War going on, and if you. Where's one where somebody's fighting him? I can never find one of these when I'm looking for it. I know I was looking at this earlier, and there was one right around here. Are you kidding? You are just giving me a big middle finger here, huh, game? Was it inside Merrick that I was looking? No, I'm pretty sure it was inside the Capellan Confederation. Anyway, sometimes these planets are active factions or multiple factions, and like say I'm supporting the Capellan Confederation. Anytime I would do missions for them, it helps them actually gain control over the planet, and it has to do with surrounding systems as well. Likewise, if there's somebody who's really not wanting to be just like a mercenary, but they're more wanting to work with, Steiner or the Lyran Commonwealth or the Free Worlds League here, they can go and do missions there if they have them and try to gain control of the planet as well. In fact, I'm pretty sure that a few of these systems right here belong to the Capellan Confederation at this point in time. I'm just almost sure that actually some of this map belongs to them and they've lost it. It seems to me, every time I look through the battle reports of who's taken planets, that Steiner takes far more than everybody else, so I'm really assuming there's just a lot of Steiner players here. Alright, so let's see what kind of mechs we got. So, because of my choices of Lao, we do always start with the Vindicator. Looks like we got a. What is that? It's a Venom. Okay, I thought that was a spider type. Got a stinger. I don't recognize any of these. Okay, the cicada I do and the javelin I do. So a little different. I haven't tried, even just resetting a bunch just to see what I get here. So a couple new mech types that I actually saw this one in Molten Metal's Let's Play. I don't know if it's the same type. Heavy PPC. Yeah, I think that might actually be. No, he had a snub nose on his. You're always going to get the Vindicator when you go with Lao, though. It's kind of like their starter. I do wish there was a couple choices, just I know a lot of people wouldn't like that. Kind of interesting. Null signature system, Guardian ECM, and we're going to be having ECM, stealth suits, and null signature systems all over the place. So, honestly, though, this mech, one slot open. So, if you essentially want to kind of make this mech your own. It's not just like you just got to be able to find out how to free some weight up on this, like throw later in the game some advanced materials to gain, maybe half ton. If it's tier 2, tier 3, you would gain 0.75 tons. And then, you can start customizing it that way. That doesn't work for this mech because this mech is completely full except for one slot. You essentially have to pull stuff off of it to do that. And I probably will be doing that because the plasma cannon can be quite good with the 2.3 bonus damage on overheating targets. Thing is, you probably have to have some other real flamer units in your lance, because just a single flamer, it's pretty hard to get them overheating with just those couple of weapons right there. Anyways, Vindicator, I really like it a lot, and we'll be going over the ECM and NSS or stealth systems shortly, because I have to make a decision in the not too distant future. How paper is your armor? Wow, not paper at all. Okay. Okay, I would definitely try to get a little bit more armor on the back there, I'm not gonna lie. PPC capacitor and a heavy PPC. How many Alpha Strike of 55 heat, 66. And you got ferrous fiber. Yeah, we'll probably be taking that off, I think. We're gonna see what the stinger is. That sounds like a long range fire support. Four lasers and four. Well, we'll just go in here and look at it. Look like four ballistic, four lasers, and yeah, four support. So, double heat sinks, five. Looks like we've got two, five in the mech as well. Medium laser plus five laser damage, small laser, medium laser plus. It's not bad. I will say that this thing should be able to basically jump every turn, though, because your alpha strike should be extremely low. 41 heat and you sink 60. Okay, so you probably can't jump every turn, but it shouldn't be too far from that. Whoa, you're a light mech as well. This is actually kind of bad. It's getting scary. I don't remember what other mech is, but this is not looking good. A cicada and a javelin. Which javelin is this? Is this the four medium lasers? I mean, the cicada actually pretty decent armor. The venom very good armor. You have paper armor though. And you have not paper, but definitely not good. I would be extremely worried about utilizing that mech. Let's see what we got on the Jenner. Oh, two AC light AC fives and two light AC twos. I love this cicada. It's probably my favorite version that I found so far in the game. The lights deal still good damage. So a flexible weapon AC five strike a balance between long range, power, and performance. I think it's the range that really suffers on these. These weapons are common found on mechs as their primary source of reliable damage. Okay, so it's not going to tell you about the light. The tonnage on a AC-5, I believe, is 9 tons. So this only weighs 5 tons. The damage on the light, or excuse me, AC-5 normally is only 40 damage, though, but I think the range is like 550, 650, something like that. As far as the max goes, the optimal's even more different. The light AC again, tonnage has gone down. Damage should be 25 on a normal AC2. This is only a 20. Again, the range looks like I believe 750 is the max on this, and I don't remember what the optimal would be. But a short range light mech is something I personally don't like to have a lot of. If they have, really kind of low armor values overall, because it's very easy to just whammy these once, and if my opponents land a hit with, an AC 10 or something, I'm in serious trouble wherever that hits. And if they happen to have gotten a back shot, I'm in really bad trouble. How do you? That's a very odd setup that those are not denominations of 5 or 10. Okay, well, whatever. I do like this, and I like to have a long range sniper or fire support or whatever you want to call it. So that is quite good. Unfortunately, everything else. I mean, the Vindicator's quite good. How is the range and the damage on this thing? 110 damage. Ooh, a recoil of 3, though. It does have damage fall off. And I can't read the how far the damage fall off is on that, although it really shouldn't matter here. That thing has so much heat just coming from the heavy PPC. I would say Oh, and it's got the PPC capacitor. I wonder if that's counting the extra 15% damage in and extra heat in. Might be. I'll probably go with this. It's got still 625 armor. Not Not terrible. The real question is, do I want to go with the javelin, or do I want to go with the stinger here? What's the medium laser pluses? Plus 5 laser damage. Okay. Plus 1 heat generated. Okay. Negative 1 accuracy though. Ooh, especially negative accuracy early in the game. That is a real kind of ball buster in my opinion. It does look like it's a little more short range too, 180, 330. Okay, no, that's the same. So you can kind of offset the negative there because laser weapons do have the accuracy, inherent accuracy bonus of plus one, so it's not like a plus zero basically. 480 or 360. Wow, that is so very bad. Is there room for armor on you? I would have to pull the jump jets off. Oh my goodness, you are honestly armored up really well. This is not a mech we're going to be utilizing here. We'll go ahead and use the javelin, which I'm not terribly thrilled with anyways. Okay, so let's go ahead and pop in and take a quick peek at our mech warriors. Gator, that's who I went with. Really, I went with double tax. I mean, I don't think I can get all the way up to it. Oh, I can. That's great news. So we have the ace pilot, and after that, we will come down for sensor lock, which kind of makes him like my light pilot almost, but not much I can do. Okay, so you have the ability. Skills, I guess I'll just mention, are a little bit different than in the base game, and they also have these cool little things to them, like brave bonus to resist pilot panic if you got. You know, a assault mech, not as in weight, but I think it's called close assault or whatever. Like tag on a mech, and that's really how you're using it. Maybe a brawler or something like that, that you're going to get in close, and you're probably going to take some damage on, you know, maybe a bigger, slower mech like a hunchback or something like that. Brave really stops them from panicking and then eventually leaving. So very good skill on those type of mechs. Honestly, you're not really helpful. You're not really helpful.
I'm receiving you.
Oh my god, it's Cyclops. What about Jean Grey? Lucky chance to avoid getting wounded. That would almost, I would say that's probably not as good, and I've never utilized anybody with bookish until I had to. And I don't know how much that reduces their other skills by. Okay, Glitch, you also have Brave, so we want you. And Medusa has cautious penalty to hit and be hit, so we definitely want her. In fact, if we can find another person with that, we will take it. We did not. All right, so Behemoth, I do like the Juggernaut, the ability to get a brace after a melee attack, do some damage, and get that defensive bonus. That's nice, and you can knock him back in initiative phase. Probably of limited use as the game goes on, but quite good for a majority of it. Glitch was the other. Wait, no. We need. We need somebody that was reckless, which I don't see, so we'll just take Big Sly, why not? So, Big Sly is going to be my long range gunner. I really like the ace pilot on most of my pilots. Most of my pilots, we'll just leave it at that. And then Glitch. All right, there we go. So I'm fairly happy with those pilot setups. Contract's a little wonky, and this does kind of lag for a moment here, so I'm sorry about that. I think this taps into the online to look at the missions and what's currently happening, like with the war and stuff, because again, the Fourth Secession War here is kind of a dynamic thing going on that other players are playing, and when they contribute to a war effort, it goes to the servers, you know, have harebrained schemes, and then it's shot back, you know, to various other players sitting at their keyboards. along with, the gear or the store and stuff. So this is almost always wrong. I've never seen it be right the first time I do it. So we're going to head to the Argo. We're going to head to the Argo. Now, there's two choices here. The second day always has the Yang event where you can gain a few extra mech tech points, I believe 3. The two options here, that will happen on the second day. On the second day, you also get, like I talked about, all of that cool stuff, like all that ECM and stuff. We don't have any of that yet. That all arrives on day two as well. So what you can do is you can go in, do a contract on your first day, second day come out, and have that boost to repair your mechs up. Or if you've really kind of know what you're doing with your gear and have some idea, you can literally just go into the Argo here, and because I have so many light mechs, I'm 100% doing this. Pass a single day, move only a small amount of supplies. Now, I do have the mech tech points here, or the tech points. Why do I keep saying mech tech? Now, we do have the tech points here, and we now have the items inside of our area, and I can actually start souping the mechs the way I personally want to play them. Cicada. That'll get some ECM on it, but generally, that's not going to get a whole lot of stuff on it overall. Oh, yeah, we're not using you. Okay, so refit the Venom here. I almost forgot what the name of this mech was. How's your heat efficiency? 66 sinking, 55. Okay, so I can actually pull off some double heat sinks here. But I am going to be sprinting around a lot, and I'm not sure that's counting in the capacitor here. Let's see. Let's just take a gander here. That's actually, I don't know if that's counting or not, because it's not actually off yet. So what we essentially need to do is we need to pull the ferrofibrous off. We have a Venom, and what the hell was he? It was a Javelin, I believe. The Venom's probably more important, I'm gonna say. So yeah, we're gonna go ahead and do the Venom here. So, wow, I could probably get some small lasers on this thing later, which would be a great idea. So I basically need to come up with 3/4 of a ton here, and how am I going to do that? That's only 1 ton. I mean, we do it. We pull the double heat sink off. Because there's really nothing else I can do here to get this. Ooh, but I need the ECM. Where am I going to be able to fit ECM in on this thing? Alright, I think we just have to go with the ECM because that's only 1 ton. I think we pull the PPC capacitor off here. I hate to do that, but I think that that's the only way I'm going to be able to get weight at this point to set this mech up correctly. So yeah, we pull the PPC capacitor off. Okay, so that leaves me with, just get rid of one armor point, that way I'm at a correct number here. I really want the Angel ECM on here, so I'm trying to see. So I'm still over a fair amount. And that heavy PPC is just monstrous. I don't think I can. I mean, there's nothing to pull at this point but armor, so we're not going to do that. We're going to do that, but we need some advanced materials first before I can throw the Angel ECM on here, what we're going to have to do is go with just a regular old ECM, which will allow us to throw an SS on here. So this is again going to run a little hotter. We got a quarter ton. I mean, honestly, just armor up. You know what, we're going to leave those at 35s, and I think we're going to bump that up to a 50. There we go. Okay, so let's go ahead 2 days and 5,000, and this will make a little sense. I'm going to come back and talk about this shortly. Honestly, I really wish I had like a snub nose. No, we're not doing that. We are not doing that at all. What we're going to do is send this little stinger, because I will never use this. It's far too flimsy. We're going to send the mech to storage and all of its equipment. That's going to save me some money on my financial report each month. But more importantly, that is going to free up some medium plus lasers, which honestly not probably great, but we can pull off the heavy PPC. Then we've got a bunch of these medium laser pluses. Where are all your laser? You should have 4 points. Where are they? Okay, both torsos. So something like that, and then something like that, and then we can pull the PPC capacitor off because we're not using a PPC anymore. And we have a ton of room at this point, so we pull the ferrofibrous off. Let's go into the equipment. This means that we can go ahead and Angel ECM might be better, but we're going to go with the Warframe Suite because this is 3 tons. And that's an extra ton that I'm going to have to be able to fit on a separate light mech, which I have no guarantee that I'm going to be able to do that, you know, in any regards. Then we throw the NSS on here. Honestly, we've got room for one more laser, so let's go ahead and grab up the other small laser here. That's a large laser. Grab up the small laser here. That's basically just to fill in a little bit of space, because, I don't have anything else I can really... I wonder where I got the heatsink kit. I've never had one of those before. They came off that, I don't really have anything else, and we're just short some weight here, so what we are going to do is laugh at myself for thinking I was going to do that. Ha 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 ha. We're going to go into the weapons, and we're going to throw on a couple of arc welders, because we have 2 support points in the arms. I'm honestly thinking I should pull off the double heat sink there. We will, just because this thing's not running nearly as hot now. I don't think there's really anything else I can do. I've eaten up all of its weapon points. I could probably move the small laser up to something a little more pricey and just armor up. Where's the max armor? Yeah, I still have like almost a ton and a half here. So, 17 days. Now that seems like a lot, but that's fine. We want these mechs ready to rock right out the gate. So let's go ahead and confirm that. And then we move over to the Javelin here. 4 medium lasers, if I remember correctly. Thankfully, this does not have endo steel on it. So that will actually net me a ton and a half right here. Like I said, this is always quite nice. Now, we have a ton and a half. However, again, we need to get ECM on my stuff. So we want the Angel ECM. Boy, do I want to move those jump jets. I do want to move those jump jets, because I kind of want to try to protect that Angel ECM just a little bit more. So I need another half ton. Looks like we have 12 heat sinks, and we're way over already with just the four medium lasers, and I'm going to be running a lot, so that'll eat up. Is there anything else on here that I can... Yeah, we just literally pull off one of the jump jets. There we go. The question is, do I want to pull off... These back values are way too low for me, so I think what we do is we pull off another jump jet. That'll actually save me some time, so I'm not having to move things around. Just to get a little more back armor on these. And this will all start to make a little bit of sense here when we get into the game and everybody sees what's happening. So I don't unfortunately have another null signature system. What we do have though is a stealth system. So we're gonna drop that on here, which the heat efficiency got better. I guess since I don't have jump jets as many, but no, the heat efficiency just got worse on this mech. Wow, we have another endo steel from that mech we put up. Oh, that was kind of lucky that we had that extra mech. And then we're gonna try to just fit a regular ECM onto. Probably should have looked at that javelin's other hard points. Okay, so it has two ballistic. It's got two of everything. That's one thing I do kind of like. Some of the javelins are kind of interesting in the way they you can set them up. There are a lot of options there. So let's check the cicada. We got the heavy ferro and the endo. I think that's all we need. So we did not need the endo steel this game. Boo, 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 boo. So we have AC, we have caseless AC5 ammo, caseless AC2 ammo. Caseless ammo allows you to actually carry a lot more ammo. This carries 38 instead of the normal 25. It has a additional 50%. AC5 has 15, so that should be, I don't know, 22. No, that's not the where's the AC5 ammo caseless? It comes with 23. Okay, so my math is bad. So I think we're just going to take the flamer off and just throw an ECM on here. This is now a short range, or excuse me, a long range sniper. If something gets in range for my flamer, things are already going terribly. So the only thing we're going to do now is get the ECM on here. Is there anything else that's completely useless? There is not, but can I save any more? What's your heat efficiency looking like? 30, so 10 heat sinks. I can't actually scrounge up any more there. Looks like we do have endo steel and heavy ferro, so that's really nice having the heavy ferro here. That actually lets this thing have a little bit more armor. I think what we want to do is we just want to sacrifice the arms though in the near future. Obviously, I don't quite have the points to do it right now. Sacrifice the arms basically, and put this all into like all of the ammo into one of these sides here, and basically put a case with it. If I could get a case, what is it, case 2 or case Mach 2 or whatever it is, that only allows the ammo explosion point damage to be, I think, 5 points or something like that, I would definitely grab one of those. Although I think it's 1 ton, it's gonna be a little hard to fit. I would need like an ultra light engine. Oh boy, boy. What do we got here? 3 more tons. Oh. And did we have a gyro on that too? That would be kind of nice. We do not. Okay. So I think I've got some cases. I think we start with cases. No? Okay. So let's see what we got in the store for cases. Now, I will say, just. It's not terrible to buy things, but what you have to realize is that the necessary upgrades is a 90,000 and a 700,000. So 790,000 of your starting 2 to 2.25 million C bills should already be spent. You should not spend that money on anything else. I would highly suggest the 450,000 out of the 90,000 as well. I'm going to be doing that. So if you look at that, like 700,000, 450, that's 1.15. And then you have, 99, 180, so that's 1.25, 1.33, so it leaves you with around 700,000 in case things go bad early in the game, because sometimes you will run into a lance that's far more powerful. I would really limit your spending to, probably 250,000, maybe 300,000. That's really where I try to keep mine in. And sometimes you'll see some great deals here. Like here we've got the case too. This is very expensive, but this will reduce ammo explosion damage to only 3 points of damage. For an extra ton, I don't know. We're actually going to go back because I'm wondering if the XL engine would not have been better suited on the, because I completely forgot I had a mech to strip. Okay, so the Venom actually did have the XL engine. I don't really have any SRMs. I already used my arc welders. I don't have any ballistic weapons, so I could armor up a little more, yet it doesn't really seem worth it. I think the XL engine here is what I need to do. I mean, I really honestly wish I could maybe fit a large laser on here too, but I think that's it's kind of pushing the level of insanity there to even contemplate it. So we'll throw the XL engine on here. I mean, this thing has no slots left with that XL engine. It's eaten up everything, so if I pull the flamer off, that's a case, but I can't really even armor up. Yeah, we're not going to put the XL engine on here because that literally eats up every slot on here. We are going to instead remove the flamer and just drop a good old-fashioned. So it would be kind of nice to armor up here, but it's not important on a long-range mech like this. Just get the ECM on here. So let's go ahead and confirm that. Just a day here. So I think that this is the problem with Lao. I don't know it for sure, but it really seems like a lot of this lost tech in the base game is worth an extreme amount of make the changes easily reversible, so good enough. It's cramped on the ship. They're moving some walls around illegally. Okay, so we have that. Now we go back to the ship upgrades here, and we immediately pick up that second bay. It'll take a bit, but we'll get it done. What's that, about 10 days? So what you see is that when I finish up, I'm not really going to be able to utilize it right here. Oh well. In the morning briefing, Falcon and we're going to train. So I have the power conduit, so this will give them a little bit of experience, so good enough. I'm honestly not going to read through these too much. I'm just kind of curious what the outcomes are. Okay, so there goes our tech points have expired. So this actually will help. It should speed this up just a hair right there. Let's ship upgrade. We're going to, what is it, automation was right here because it moves forward one once I unlock the second bay. Alright, so you see this money, I haven't bought anything yet and I'm pretty much burning up a whole month. I will say this is not normal here to burn up an entire month. You get a message, after the message is strayed, my boys tell me that you have a glitch on your cruise. Well, I need to tell you the glitch is not a get to be blunt. She's a thief and a backstabber, and only common decency had me leave her on the station instead of booting her through the airlock when I finally fired her ass. I know. Trust me, buddy. I know. My entire crew, I want to throw. Well, minus Yang. Yang's not a complete idiot. Pretty sure everybody else on my crew ate lead paint chips, lots of them as children. So I get the feeling they're not so much that they were thieves or everything, but they're just complete idiots. So be careful with your crew and keep in mind. No, we want to keep. I I've never had this one, so I don't know. Let's go with this one. So, gains the tag dependable. Okay. Yeah, I got fired for refusing to follow stupid orders. Hey, thanks for asking about it. Instead of just believing him, I knew you were a good one. Honestly, you're one of the pilots that I like to use on some of my mechs, so not a lot of choice there. And it looks like we have actually finished our thing, so we'll talk about why I've installed all this ECM and everything on here, because this is pretty funny. We do not want to do a one skull, and anything that is a where is one? Capture the base. Do not do capture the bases. Do not do... There's capture the base and destroy the base, I think, is the other one. Those, yeah, destroy the base. Do not do those missions with these lances. First off, I think something's terribly bugged with either my lance at the time or some of the gear that comes here. Even with, like, the Null Signature System's negative 35% sensor range, I was being sensor locked by the turrets at the edge of the map. And I was like 4 or 5 turns from even getting into the turret's range. Like, I actually started getting deep scanned by them. Excuse me, it's not sensor lock, it's deep scanned by the turrets. I started getting deep scanned in them because I accidentally came around a hill and I was like, oh, well, I just got to be a little more careful. So I'll just pull back and I was like, wow, I'm still getting deep scanned. And wow, I'm still getting deep scanned. And then, like, I hit the edge of the map and I'm just like, I can't go any farther. Like, there's just turrets just, like, blowing up all of my mechs from just, like, crazy levels. Like, it's just insane. Just insane. Don't do these types of missions with your lance. If you try to build it like this, you will regret it. We'll go straight for the assassination here. So there will be definitely a medium mech here. And we want maximum salvage, because if we can get multiple parts from it, we want it. Alright, so let's go ahead and get the Vindicator. You're my tanky. Cicada, you're my fire support. I guess Venom, you're my second kind of tanky. Okay, so Gator. I think I was getting you onto a Javelin type setup. Behemoth, you're always in that position, and I mean, it really didn't matter what I threw on you. You just got to be a high gunner. Yeah, so you, that looks right. Let's go ahead and deploy. Yeah, that's fine. That's fine. So I may instantly regret not just crap canning this setup. I love that Cicada, though. And I'm kind of interested to try out the Venom. That Stinger or whatever it was, I don't know what type of mech that is off the top of my head. But 20 tons with that kind of low armor and just, like, medium lasers? Like, whoa. Whoa, whoa, so bad. So bad. Even coming from area where I can throw this kind of ridiculous evasion on my stuff. And if nobody's figured it out, and you don't know what the stealth systems and the null signature systems do, I think you're going to be a little impressed, but you do got to be very careful of deep scans from those turrets, like I said. They will wreck you. They will absolutely wreck you. Yeah, needless to say, that was a lost playthrough. My Vindicator did fight all the way through. There was only, like, 3 freaking vehicles left in all 4 turrets. The Vindicator made it through, but there was nothing. I lost 3 fusion cores, and my Vindicator was... I don't think it... Did it have any weapon systems left? Must have, because I took the turrets out, but it was bad. It was really bad. Come on, hurry up and load, hurry up and load. So, terrorist, but sort of extra maneuvering is why they're hired instead of using the... Still best to be alert for anything. Yeah, there should be a second lance here, that's fine. There's always some backup. Are we going to see him right out the gate? We might, because we have all kinds of extreme warfare gear. Really? The cicada is a medium mech. I always forget it. It's. Okay. So we're gonna have two lances plus a medium mech. Okay, that's interesting. Thankfully, we didn't start right in battle. This is actually going to be kind of a rough mission here, and I don't know how these two lights are going to hold up here. I guess we will find out. So, where's the leader at? Up there. I mean, I do not think I want to. That's all, yeah, that's all marshland. What do I want to do? What do I want to do? Wow, you are so very fast. I don't even have to sprint to get you to be that fast. Okay. We're gonna actually, because we know they have at least one medium mech here. I'm gonna be really pissed if they have more than one medium mech. Because this is gonna be a bit ridiculous and et cetera, et cetera. So, I think what we do is, wow, did they moved something in the last 3 seconds? I might be running a little hot. I'm almost thinking try to sweep up and take out whatever's up here, but I'm fairly certain I'm gonna just bump into whatever's up there, because they're usually not just right there. There'll be some, here and some back here. So I'm almost thinking engage. We'll reserve back once more just to see if anything comes into sight here. Okay. Okay, oh, we do see machine gun locust here. Thankfully, these are ramshackle, thank goodness. So, don't gotta get a lot of hits here, but this is what you do with the systems here. So I have, I don't remember which one I threw on here. Okay, this has the Warframe suite. So the Warframe suite is plus one maximum evasion pips. Plus one maximum evasion pips from just moving at all. Plus one to your ability to hit. And then I think some negatives to sensors and things like that. So basically, I'm gaining plus one evasion pip from just moving. Then on this mech, we have a null signature system. Now, the null signature system, it will generate 6 heat per turn. The stealth actually does 6 heat per turn as well, which is kind of a little absurd considering it's not as good. It is going to produce not only 6 heat per turn, but your weapons are going to heat up 10% more. However, the null signature system is going to give you plus two maximum evasion, plus two evasion when you just generally move at all. So even if I move one space, I'm getting at least four evasion pips up, which is a lot. And when I start sprinting, you will see like the fastest mechs early in the game because you don't have the requisite points to get any higher, but what you'll have is you'll have four evasion pips. This thing has seven on it. This thing is incredibly dodgy. Unfortunately, fighting here in the Capellan Confederation, many of the mechs you're fighting have taggers, they have narcs, they have ECMs themselves, they have a. There's a lot of really crazy laser boats down here. Kind of like I've built here, honestly. There's some really absurd laser boats you will find down here. So you basically just build extremely dodgy lances. Now it is kind of hard when you have like some of the low armor Jenners or some of the low armor Javelins, things like that, because if something just does happen to hit you explode you into little pieces. So this many lights can be not just problematic, it can be terrible. But like, here's a Vindicator. This is a. 45-ton medium mech, right? And this also has a Guardian ECM, so plus one just to not be hit, much like the Angel ECM has a plus one not to be hit. The Angel ECM is a little bit better, but it does weigh a half ton more because it has the negative two sight range when you're in cover, which is the forest, and negative sensor range on it. All right, so 51% with the plasma cannon. I mean, we're not going to do this. I'm just going to point something out right here. When you... can I see it from here? No. So when you fire without moving, there's really no negatives to your hit. The negatives are actually positives in this game, though. Vindicator, let's go ahead and move. When you move forward, just movement, you get a plus one to your hit, which is really a negative, so it makes it like one harder to hit. And if you sprint, that gives you a negative two to hit. But the thing is, sometimes getting the optimal distance with your weapons will actually increase your chance to hit far more than the negatives of like a sprint or a walk rather than even just standing still. So I really, really kind of like this. And we're going to be right near that medium, so hopefully we can pop this locust fast. Okay, we popped you with that. Where did we hit you at? Oh, on the center.
Yes, Commander.
We don't have anything that's really, honestly, capable. Now, you're going to see the Javelin only has a... Excuse me, the Javelin has the... I think it's got the Angel ECM, so plus one chance for not being hit. Plus two evasion, but it's only got, or plus one to the evasion, but it's only got a stealth. So I think the stealth armor is honestly a little big. Both the stealth and the null signature systems are basically the same thing. The stealth is only plus one to your evasion, though. Plus five to your heat from your weapons, but it's, I don't remember. It's not quite as much basic heat. It doesn't have the sensor and the cover bonus either. But both of them take six reserve slots, which is really my big sticking point on this. So you can see this mech's not quite getting what appears to be like full pips here, and that's fine. So what we're going to do is just keep going like breakneck speed. Still six evasion, though. Quite good. And that's why I basically trash can that other one, because if I get hit by anything, it's dead. And we want to keep the cicada just as back, just as far as we can. So 50s, 50s. Oh, 63s. What if we sprint just to get the other ones in line? I mean, I think we just take the 63s. Those are not bad.
Engaging target.
Okay, there's a ammo explosion. Looks like we destroyed the gyro. Engine destroyed too. Beautiful. So that's a part of the defense force here. Okay, so we know they have one medium. We got another mech here, unknown there. Those are both lights. So this works a little differently. Normally, I just like to keep pushing at the enemy when I played with like Drake's Combine and Lyran Commonwealth. But I generally have a wholly different type of thing. I try to get something like that Hunchback 4GG that the Lyran Commonwealth starts with, alongside like another big wall of steel up front, and then I usually like to have you know, at least one range fire support back here, and the other one I kind of switch that up depending upon what mechs I get with the lance. This lance plays very differently. I honestly want them all to move and shoot unless I can essentially just wipe a mech out, and that'll make a little bit of sense when you realize that I have like 8 billion evasion points.
Copy that.
So Are you going to reserve back? All right, so I guess we take... No, we don't. We reserve back again, just see if they do it.
Until an opportunity presents itself.
Waiting on you, Commander.
Okay, see, this actually gains a ton of movement with that huge engine it has just from its movement. I don't even have to sprint with this thing. I think I am going to sprint. Because I really want the... This will give me a couple of targets. We're going to torso just try to keep things from getting behind me, at least right now. Although things getting behind me is not maybe the worst. You're an urban mech? They want me to assassinate an urban mech. Oh, no. There's the Shadowhawk. I was going to say, there's always a mech higher class up. So let's go ahead and AC-10 version. It's going to be kind of hard to hit, but if it hits, it's crippling to me. Double fusion core crit. Did we take it out? Nope. Unsettled, though. Cicada, can you get eyeballs on it? You can. So let's go ahead and... There we go. AC-10 ammo explosion. 2 mechs down. So far, they haven't fired anything back at me. I'm kind of glad I could see the Shadowhawk. What shadow... Oh! What kind of medium lasers are, though? Oh, yeah, you can't see what they have. I can always see what I have. Can't I? I guess not. I thought you could. Maybe I'm just a moron. Well, I mean, I know I'm a moron, but maybe I'm just more of a moron than I realized. This is the least evasive of my guys. Do I really want it? The Shadowhawk has not moved yet. It does have the damage reduction of 25% from the entrenched. But while this hasn't moved, we do probably want to get some shots in against it. And you're terrible, Javelin. Gator, just go home. Go home. You're drunk. And hopefully, I don't think we can really get the Vindicator into range here either. Let's see, though. Okay, we can get the medium lasers in range. Going full throttle. And hopefully we'll draw the fire from that 1A, which is the large laser. Large laser negative, okay. Okay, that's a fine shooting, everybody. Fine shooting. I could see that. Okay, so they miss. And you're going to see this a lot. They are going to miss me a lot. I just really have to watch out for my cicada back here. Oh, I got hit with 111, so that would be a small pulse laser. Or, excuse me, medium pulse laser. So, if we come up here and look at the Shadowhawk, that looked like maybe not an Alpha Strike, because I did not see the fluid gun there. But that was 1, 2, 3, 4. Those were not pulse lasers? Oh, it does have a medium pulse laser at the bottom. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5... 6 weapons shooting, and the medium pulse actually shoots 3 times, and each one of those has to roll to hit. So that was 8 attacks, and it only managed to land 1 on my mech. That is so good. Unfortunately, the Venom, kind of the weaker of my guys, or did you shoot at the Vindicator? If you shot at the Vindicator, that was just stupid, because it's a pretty good block of armor on top of all that evasion. Oh yeah, you're medium. I keep thinking you're a light. Okay, now here's the thing, and why I really wanted to throw a little back armor on these guys up here. Whenever you go for a flank, you do get a bonus to hit. The blue line is the flank you maneuver. Whenever you get behind them, you can't get behind them. So let's look at you. Whenever you get behind them, the green line, that's going to ignore the damage reduction from cover or being braced, as well as give you a good chance to hit. You're always in danger of being flanked yourself or a back shot. So basically, if I came around here and did a back shot on the Shadowhawk right now, that Shadowhawk on its turn, if I don't kill it, easily can move, you know, 1, 2, 3, 4 spaces and then get a back shot on me. And same thing with if you just go to the sides for like a fairly close flanking maneuvers. Whenever you flank or whenever you take back shots, you have to be prepared to take those in turn. The thing is, with a very dodgy group, I have no problem with giving them a little extra hit chance for getting behind me or getting on my flanks if it increases my hit chances. So yeah, I'm more than good with that. I think what we do is we reserve. Yeah, we reserve, because I want to see if somebody starts going after the cicada, I'll run away and... I think we might just take a bad shot with the cicada this turn just to sprint up here, so I'm not... And this is the thing, they can throw firepower at everything all day long. The only thing that I have that's weak is the cicada. That is like the weakness in my group here. Honestly, that's got a ton of evasion on it. We're going to reserve back one more time, because hopefully it will go since I have a ton of mech standing right in front of it. Ooh, it did hit with the large laser. It's unfortunate. The acid gun did go off that time, so I don't know if it did last time. Maybe I didn't see it. Thankfully, we're not on too weak of a thing, but you do have to keep kind of track of your torso twisting and stuff still. It's not like you can just really, you know, ignore everything. I mean, that's 17 and 22s. Boy, you are not able to really get out of the line there, are you? And that's just bringing you closer into it. How in the hell are you able to still see that? Is that from those up there? Okay, so I think we take the extremely long-range shot here. I'm wondering if that spider can still see me. I don't want them to come after my cicada. Okay, that's unfortunate. Oh, what am I doing? I'm supposed to do a offensive push there. I am a moron. That mech is so close to overheating.
Good to go.
All right, so where's the back on you now? So we want maximum evasion continually. It lowers my chances to hit, but they have a very hard time. It is my right side. This is also going to torso twist my right away from all the incoming mechs here. And you can see, like, this dagger right here. Look at this thing. Tag. Haywire EMP. Narc Beacon. It's got 7 evasion pips, so you know it's got ECM and probably it's Inferno ammo. What is this? Electronic Warfare Suite. So we knew it had ECM of some sort, and it should have like a stealth or less stability, active stealth armor. So it's got the stealth armor on it like my Javelin does. So you can just see, I mean, this is the sort of things you run into alongside, honestly, some really good laser boats out here. That's actually extremely dangerous to me overall. So I think what we do is, I think this is more dangerous than what I'm fighting over here. So, man, that thing has so much evasion. I don't think we go for back shots because I don't want this thing shooting me in the back with that. Oops, that's not full evasion. Okay, so that's full evasion right there, 32% chance to hit. We're still getting a flanking shot on the Shadowhawk, but did I hit?
That would be a miss.
Okay.
Standing by.
Again, we're going to go for a flanking shot. That's actually not enough movement, though. I mean, those are terrible hit chances. What about if I just move? I can't get into melee over there. Everything does kind of run hot. I'm seeing if I can't maybe do a... That's going to make it even worse, but that's okay. I can do the offensive push then on the Shadowhawk. Yeah, so we're going to probably come in for a jump. Oh, I can't see it from there. Okay, there we go. So there's maximum evasion.
Jumping.
And I'm hoping I can slide down to kind of stop that cicada from being crushed if that kind of comes to it. So we're going to go for an offensive push here because I think I'd like to try to really damage this thing before next turn, and I have basically no chance to hit anyways. Jump jetting around causes a lot of negatives to hit as well. Probably could have looked at it right there, but I think it's a negative two.
What do you need?
The water does slow me down a bit, but we're gonna go ahead and take it this turn. Try to maybe pump something into that Shadowhawk. Couple hits. Ooh. The Shadowhawk does not have ramshackle armor. I wish I would have noticed that prior to.
What can I do for ya? I hear ya.
I mean, I got lots of evasion. We're gonna just evasion it up. Unfortunately, my Venom kind of is out here tanking, and it's already got that damaged arm. I should have left my Vindicator out there. Although jump jetting so that I could have the angle. Okay, so it haywired me, and it movement impaired me. Yeah. Haywire is reduction on heat sinks. It's a reduction on your ability to be hit. Or messes with your movement, heat sinks, and was it your targeting, or is it helps their target? I think it messes with your targeting.
What can I do for you?
Okay, so basically I need to... kind of honestly keep my Venom back a little bit right now. Can we still get three just for movement? We can. Can we do it with an angle? We can. That's still pretty terrible. I mean, honestly, I think I could just start blowing mechs up over here long before I'm able to take this Shadowhawk out. I didn't realize it was not ramshackle. Alright. Sometimes you gotta swing the map around when it won't let you quite get what you want. Okay, so yeah, we go for it right here. We're going to try to take the commando out first. It's fairly easy. And I miss with everything.
Hey,
I could see that. You're bad. So apparently I did not need to do that offensive push there.
Yes, Commander.
So we're going to go ahead and sprint out. And... I mean, just hitting that dagger right now is going to be hard. So we're going to take the shot on the commando again. Take the easy targets, just get some of their firepower off the field. Wow, and I'm on a huge missing streak. Okay. That happens. It's better than the base game giving you crazy hit chances that you actually don't have. Okay, come on, please don't screw up. I mean, with everything I've thrown at this, it should be in big trouble already.
Ooh, that hit something good.
All right, so we finally got somebody to do something. Hooray! Honestly, you have a pretty good hit chance. This is my worst one at being hit overall. It's got less armor and less dodge. But we really just need to hit the commando with something. Take out a lay, take out the center. And again, we just miss with everything. I think it might have hit me with the target acquired, the tag, yeah. Tag's gonna be a little dangerous coming off that Shadowhawk there. Ooh. Can I shut it down?
I hear ya.
You know what? You got the tag on you, so I think you're the one I want to... You're the one I want to get farther back. Now, this is going to give me a little harder chance to hit, but Waiting two turns till that tag kind of wears off. That's the important part. We did not take it, so the commando will probably go now. Oh, it's not. Fire truck, Narc beacon again, so another priority target.
Waiting for order.
Excuse me, you should be able to move and shoot. I don't think you should have to be able to run. Yeah, you actually do, simply because you are haywired right now. Okay, there's my maximum evasion, and I can get some medium laser hits here. Okay, so there's the engine gone. I know that was not a priority target, but I just needed to get it off the battlefield. And we did it before it got a shoot, so that's something. We really need this dagger not to move, because I need to be able to shoot it without having to shoot it like 8 million times. Oh, crazy, crazy lances here. One damage on the tag, and what was the others there? Okay. There we go. I think we might be able to do it now. The dagger is... I'm not sure if this is a Locust, because it is an LCT, LR. So that sounds a lot like a... LCT is a Locust abbreviation, but I don't know, because it says it's a dagger type. Maybe that was just a miss there, but this is also 35 tons. That's quite a bit bigger than the Locust. I don't think I'm going to do this, but we're just going to see, because that plasma cannon will hit for over 100 damage right now, since that mech is overheating. So if I can get a good shot with the plasma cannon, I'm going to do it. Just because I could tear through the rear armor of that. So, like I said, plasma cannon 2.3, it feels like 113-ish damage or something like that. Really got a hit with the plasma cannon here. We're really hoping for that. Now, I didn't get full evasion here, I don't think. Okay, it lost its evasive, but then it gains it right back. Looks like most of that went onto the leg. Okay, so... That's... Oh, how are you not shut down? You're at max heat. Whatever. Okay, that's going to be some 30s. I've kind of got some distractions up there, so I'm thinking I might. Aww. Okay. I mean, honestly, it doesn't look like I have a chance to really hit anything else. So we'll go for the 30s right here.
Locking on.
Nope. Nothing. Whole lot of nothing.
Heat damage. Damn it.
That was no heat damage, though. Alright. We're going to try to open this thing up like a tin can on the backside. That's, I think, the most important part. I'm no longer haywired. There we go. Structure exposed, but no parts destroyed. We did get evasive, knock the evasive off, and it goes right afterwards. It's a little sad. Yeah, okay, move impaired and cooling impaired. I thought it was, I really thought that also screwed with the ability to hit. I really did. I mean, honestly, the very small extra chance to hit there is not worth the cost of evasion. As long as I keep these above 20s, I'm good. So that's going to be about the best. And I think I'm only getting 4 here. Nope, still 5. Really? You're going to hit the leg then? Come on, Vindicator. Tank it up. You know what you're doing. Oh, are you coming around for my cicada? You better not be. That will anger me. That will anger me.
Standing by.
I mean, I think I have to go for the shot again. I'm just not getting the evasion I want, but we just have to hope I don't shut down. If I could shut the Shadowhawk down with that flamer, that would be great. Unfortunately, that was the arm. It's going to get a restart now in 2 seconds. Okay, so it only got a power up. It has no evasion, so
I'm your spaniel.
I mean, look at that. Do I take the shots or do I take the dagger out? I mean, I can take the dagger out. Ooh, that's not the dagger. Yeah, it's saying I can shoot the dagger. I just got a hit with something. I think what we're going to do is we're going to go for a vigilance here. Nope, I really need to be in sight of both of those mechs right here. There we go. Dagger down.
Are there none who can stand before me?
Did I not vigilance? Oh, I didn't hit okay.
Watch my heat. I'm taking damage.
Oh, I didn't hit okay. So, since the Shadowhawk didn't move, now I have to do... Now I got to do an offensive push on it instead to push it back around because I want lots of shots on it here. The unfortunate thing is I wanted the Cicada and the Vindicator to take shots, and the Vindicator cannot now. Oh well, things happen. That's actually a little more evasion, but we need to keep to the water right now. Water, important. Because this is very hot, and I really don't want to push down. So unlike the base game, offensive push lowers your chance to hit instead of increasing it. What's in the arm? 2 medium lasers and the tag. How much armor's on that leg? I think we go for the arm here and just try to take some of the damage of that thing off. And we miss everything anyways. I probably should have went for the center torso, actually. Yes, I see you missed. Really, I need my Vindicator over in the water. This is just too good right here of an opportunity. I am a little afraid about my Cicada getting flanked, so what we have to do is pull the dagger in to try to hold off all of this jazz over here, and that will give my Cicada and my Vindicator hopefully time to cripple it. This thing, thankfully, is running so very cold. What do we got here? 26s and 23s. Yep, that's the better. And it's only a fire starter.
Tell me what to shoot.
Oh, really? We're still not going to hit all with quarters.
Hey, stand still when I'm attacking
you. I'd say I'm way below averages so far at this point in the game. Ooh, and the, what's that? Locust, whatever that was, wasp. And I've actually, I mean, spider. I haven't seen any spiders here. It's wasp or javelin, probably. I wasn't paying attention, to be honest. which I'm sure everybody could have already figured out by now. They're like, yeah, we kind of noticed that you weren't paying attention. So the else, I mean, I want the better chance with the fives. They're a little more damage here. Okay, looks like we got three of the hits there.
Receiving you.
Okay, so I don't think they have enough firepower to punish me, but these are all really good hit chances. We are just going to push the limit with this mech right here. We may shut down because we've been pushing. All right. Do we shut down, though? Okay, no ammo explosion. We really need to kind of fall back towards the water at this point, though. My mech is in terrible danger of getting hit by, like, a fire starter and just shutting down completely. I think the cicada can still, honestly, provide a fair amount of fire support as long as the venom's up here. Get me some eyeballs on things. 26s. The bad thing about shooting in the back when I don't have others to follow up is I really have to kind of take it out because everything else is going to be shooting from the front. I'm tempted to shoot from the side here just because the cicada is going to have to take a front shot at it, but I think we're going to go for it just because there's a chance I can get like a few engine crits here. Instead, we just get some jump jets. Okay.
Want some more, huh?
I mean, they just can't hit you with this kind of evasion. It's such a beautiful, beautiful thing. Gator. Just in case somebody comes down here, I do want you to have most of your evasion. We're going to walk, actually. Just walking, and I'm even in the water, so I should be getting less evasion pips than normal. You should be able to get six. How many is that going to be just for like a walk in the water? Four? It's honestly pretty bad. But we're fully cooled down now. I can engage with another one of my small mechs. I just got to get my Vindicator into safety at this point. I should have vigilanced my Vindicator. I could have already moved it towards the water at this point. Okay, we're going to take a little extra damage simply because not moving and taking those very high hit chances on everything. I mean, I'm pretty much relying on dodges this game. So I think what we do is we jump because the water, even though the jump's really going to cost me in heat,
jumping.
It's going to get me a lot of evasion and I'll be in the water where I can cool down real fast. I could see that. Alright. Hello, little spider. I think I get slightly better hit chances. 25, 43s. Boy, those AC5s get worse. What if I really get up there? 25, 43s. I want the AC5s to hit. Two fusion core crits there. That's not bad. That must have an XL engine. It's too bad I don't have some lower damage weapons. I'd really like to get another XL engine. Okay. Good job, fire truck. I mean, I'm not sure what you did, but good job. Alright, so again, we get that full evasion up here. Can I do that just by moving? No, I cannot. And we take another back shot on the fire starter, and we try to hopefully kill it this time.
Here it comes.
Two fusion core crits. Ah, nothing though. Big fat nothing. I mean, they just can't hit you. you are giving yourself some negatives to hit too, so it's kind of a game of chicken. You really don't want this many light mechs to play it. And some of the really vulnerable strikers, again, like the Jenner and the some of the Javelin variants, and like a Wasp, and I don't remember what that one mech that I had was called, but that would be a bad one as well. Ooh, wait, why am I fighting here? We need to go to the evac. Ah, I can pick up all the parts because I did have to tear that thing to shreds, so never mind. There's not going to be too many Shadowhawk parts. I was thinking, oh boy, I want to get extra parts, but yeah, those don't exist actually here. All right, let's whoops. Bring those AC-5s to bear. Okay, machine gun crit, not as good as I was hoping for, but whatever. Yeah, you need to cool off one more full turn. That's a beautiful thing, though. I have no problem throwing two light mechs at two mechs and two vehicles right here, even with just one fire support. Like, you would normally think, oh no, my light mechs are gonna get shredded. They're fighting like 4-1, even if the damage isn't very high. They're gonna just.
Good to go.
Oh, excuse me. Did I not kill the fire starter still? Little fire starter, you are starting to get annoying. I swear I saw a. There we go. Come on, Venom. Quit screwing around and kill it. There we go.
Bang, you're dead.
And they're even getting like, that's a flanking shot right there. I'm facing this direct. Well, that might not quite be a flanking shot, but it's very close if it's not. Which one of you is damaged? No. Yes, and it's your right side, which is actually over there, so we're not going to shoot at you. Oh no, did I just run? Eh, still 5 evasion pips. Not the 6, but still 5. Good stuff. Unfortunately, we did destroy the Narc Beacon. Narc Beacons would help me out quite a bit. So we're going to burn really hot, but we're going to just do it anyways. Because I'm hoping to end it with Behemoth and the Big Sly. 56s. Ooh. That's only 6% less, but both the AC-5s now have a chance to hit. And that was pretty terrible. The repairs on these are either incredibly good on these lances like this, or they're incredibly bad. That's one thing I will kind of say, is like sometimes you're like, where are these repairs coming from? Honestly, you don't need arc welders. You are not hot at all.
Scratch another target.
I'd love to get like a couple medium pulse lasers and probably switch the small laser to a medium laser. Pull those arc welders off. Probably finish armoring up. Come on. I know you hang up sometimes, game, but don't do it to me here. That's probably an incredibly long battle. Yeah, I will say, it's kind of the one thing you will find about these is that the battles are extremely long. So, anyways, let's just see what we have here. Hopefully there's a couple Shadowhawk pieces. Hopefully. I saw the opportunity, and I just went for the throat. I'm really thinking I should have maybe just broke this into two videos. I mean, the Cicada, not damaged at all. The Javelin, not damaged at all. And these two, Honestly, more damage to the Vindicator than what I would have thought, but it happens. Where is the Shadowhawk? Oh my goodness, there were four Shadowhawks. I guess I should have ran out of there just as quickly as possible in order to try to grab that other one up. We're just going to just see if there's anything interesting here. I mean, those medium laser plus plus. Still the negative one accuracy. Plus two heat generated. This is like the one I have, but the one I have is plus five, plus one, negative one. Yeah, for the same weight, that's actually would really be nice to end up with. An arc beacon. They're so good. The thing is, I just don't ever find a good place for 3 tons. Honestly, the Venom, though, that I have, since I took that PPC off and I have that extra weight, I really hope I get an arc beacon here. I don't think SRM4s, but I don't know. Angel ECM would be good. I don't need the Endo Steel. Don't need the Ferrofiber. Fusion Cores would be good. Ultralight Gyro would be extremely good. Any double heat sinks? Heat sink cooling pod would probably be pretty decent. All the patchwork materials are always good to get your hands on. No cockpit, huh? Oh, excuse me, Warframe Suite. Or is it the Slick Suite? I don't know, one of these go over the cockpit. Oh yeah, this is the cockpit. This is the ECM you throw on your thing. Primitive cockpit's terrible, Slick Suite. So there's quite a bit of good gear here. But there is a bunch of it, too. We did not get the other Shadowhawk part. Boo. I could cry now. We didn't get anything we wanted. That sucks. That sucks, but it happens. Oh, yeah, if I could get a Shadowhawk. This is the type of setup right here where I really would love to have, like, a really nice cavalry lance where I can pop backwards really fast, shoot some PPCs, jump forward, shoot some SRMs, man, some Griffins, some Shadowhawks, Grasshoppers. With the type of equipment I'm getting, or I have right now, I would be game for days. For days. And I guess this is, you know, probably a decent place to, well, we just see Steiner took something, Lau took something, Steiner took something, Karita took a couple things, Davion took one, Lau actually took one. I don't see that very often. It doesn't look like really Free Worlds League and Lau, it doesn't look like hardly anybody. I don't see anybody playing them, but this is something I'm seeing very common is, out of all the planets taken from the war activities while I was playing that game, four of them were for Steiner. Steiner just took four planets. And did Steiner lose anything? Steiner lost zero planets. I have a feeling Steiner's going to win. 20,000, that's actually kind of harsh considering where I'm at. Oh, I don't have the automation done, so yeah. Anyways, thanks for watching. Sorry for the ridiculously long video. Hope you've enjoyed, and until next time.